Hello everyone, it's me again, Shikin. This is the final episode for Mud Trap Show, episode 10. For those who haven't watched the previous episode, you can find the link at the description. Previous episode, we already discussed the challenge in Minecraft farming. In this episode, we will talk about the unique strategy advantages in Minecraft farming. The main driver of growth is due to the rising population, which is expected to reach 8 billion in the year 2022, along with the decline in the captured fisheries. The food production will have to increase by 70% within the next 40 years to feed the population. Mud crab aquaculture has also been forecasted to grow due to the high demand in Asia. Hence, investors have joined the mud crab industry, aiming at filling the gaps of the industry. The importers for mud crab include China, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Taiwan, Japan, as it is predominantly an Asian delicacy. The Chinese consumer demand for mud crab has been growing at a staggering pace throughout the past 2 to 3 years. In 2019, it has been reported that Chinese buyers could set up buying stations in the Philippines, Vietnam and Sri Lanka and offering a premium of $1 to $2 per kilo higher to farmers and fishermen. Meanwhile, countries like Malaysia and Thailand that used to be able to catch mud crab from the wild have also started to import from other producers. One of the most popular questions from our course attendees are, where should I set up my mud crab farm? Upside of being near the coast as compared to an urban area include easy access to seawater. While some operators prefer to be located near the urban areas and close to the client they serve. However, the location of your farm should not be a big issue with vertical farming technology. You can set up your system anywhere as long as you understand the current crab demand near you. Interestingly, you can do it indoors. However, mud crab supply can fall due to bad weather and high demand. Mud crab would have been flushed out of their holes or hiding area when there is heavy rainfall. At this time, you would probably have a good catch. However, during hot weather, it would cause 10 to 15% of crab to die during transit. Having vertical mud crab farming technology indoor helps to weather against changing weather patterns. This ensures all year round production if you are not depending on the wild catch. Another advantage of vertical mud crab farming is you can have a good inventory control. Having the crab house individually for each crab make it easier to record the incoming, behavior, health status and exit of the crab. Besides, you should also know which crab already inside the system for a long period and need to be sold. By doing so, it would be easier for you to estimate the volume of crab should be sold before any festive. Here in our farm, we use the in-house software to track inventory. As you can see here, we have kept the record of crab. From here, we can put the incoming date, species, weight, supplier name and their status. Next, by having these vertical crab houses, you would be able to be competitive due to low logistical costs. Some crab traders, they didn't have the storage or holding facility until the crab sold. This type of traders also popular in the mud crab business. However, the risk they are facing is especially on the logistical cost. They might need to frequently import the mud crab because they cannot hold the mud crab for a long period. Due to the COVID-19, mud crab trading also get impacted, especially on the mud crab exporter, Indonesia. This is due to the lack of demand from the Chinese suppliers. With the outbreak COVID-19, the Indonesia exporters have found themselves with excessive amount of 200 to 300 gram size crab. It might be useful at this point to clarify that most exporters have to purchase all sizes available from the fishermen to prevent other exporters from poaching their supplier. As Malaysia and Singapore are not as badly affected as China, the demand for 500 to 700 gram persisted. As a result, much of the 200 to 300 gram sizes are not being sold, resulting in high mortality on the exporter side. As a result, to reduce the backlog of these smaller size crabs, the exporter have to impose condition for importers to buy a certain quantity of 200 to 300 gram size crab for every 500 to 600 gram size crab order. Customers nowadays are always looking for a good quality seafood product. For mud crab, good quality is defined by the texture, sweetness and fullness of the crab. You can always ensure that you are providing a high quality mud crab by controlling their food and living environment. For example, we always supply the crab with vitamin which mix with the feed. The vitamin can help to boost up their immune system and improve their resistance towards disease outbreak. In any aquaculture industry, the mortality issue is a great concern that most people are afraid to take the risk. Aside from improving the mud crab health, water quality also plays a big aspect in mud crab farming. Indoor farming attract more younger generation to invest in aquaculture. This is because farming no need to relocate to suburban areas with pond or large land areas. Different from seafood restaurants which need to be located near the resident and main road, indoor farming can be done in any location. You just need to understand the customer demand in your area and improve your sales and marketing. With the crab houses concept, the people who would like to learn before investing more on the system can make a small setup first. For example, set up 100 to 200 boxes and you probably want to DIY your filtration system to understand the workflow so that you will be more confident to expand the vertical farming. We have reached the end of the episode. To recap, in this episode, we already discussed the unique strategy advantages despite the challenge in mud crab farming. We believe mud crab farming is an interesting field to venture for future seafood sustainability. But before you proceed to invest in this field, there is a lot to learn from theory to practical knowledge. We are happy to share with you some of the information on the vertical mud crab farming on our YouTube channel. To know more on the mud crab farming business, we also provide training course which will cover both theory and practical aspects. Don't hesitate to contact us via email to get more details on the course. Thanks for watching.